God said, let there be light. And we the light, because we as witnesses. That light represented all light that we've been witnessing, but don't take it lightly. Because that's the same light that plants need for photosynthesis. So if the plants need the sun and we eat the plants, you should see how dynamic this whole system is. He did the first invention. His precision was so intricate. He painted the sky and the earth. But for us, he put his emphasis. Imagine the earth ran by nothing but God's images, creating time from a place where time's limitless. Formed Adam from the dust of the ground and he was innocent. Thank God for Genesis. I mean, every quote, every phrase, all lines, all sentences. He gave us a body with a spine. We just a copy of his mind, the same mind we make decisions with. What's a signature without a penmanship? Two trees in the garden, planted them in the midst of it. One life, one imprisonment. It's like the garden was an island. And just like there's two trees, there's always two forces colliding. It's like God really banking on my spirit. But Satan trying to make a deposit. There is death in the other, but the tree of life means survival. You can eat from this, but the other, he didn't advise it. And since the word is God, still today the tree of life is the Bible. And then came the serpent out of hiding with a purpose full of violence. He envied us because of what's living inside us. Of course he see that we godly. He was cast out of heaven and his worshiping was silence. He told Eve, eat. She was thirsty for the knowledge, not knowing it was death and a version of a prophet. So first lesson in Genesis, just cause it sorta makes sense, don't mean your spirit profits. You pick a topic while we unravel all the pages. Light versus dark, that's a battle for the ages. Eve had two sons, one from Adam, one from Satan. One wicked, one good, today same battle that we facing. Opportunity the same, except one was battered and forsaken. Cain brought blasphemy, that's when tragedy awakened and killed Abel. And even though he shedded his blood, what he didn't know is this condition was still stable. He had a replacement, so it's really like he never left. It all coexists. It's like God made Abel on the day that he created Seth. I thank God for Genesis. I'm talking all of the chapters, all of the good, all the disasters, all of the tears, all of the laughter, the Garden of Eden, the Tower of Babel, everyone then and everyone after. And after the tower, the people were scattered. The hearts of man were so wicked, God looked down and repented that we existed. Homosexual itches, murders, lynches, giant beasts. The faith was resistant, rape consistent, sorcerers, magicians, and the plagues of the witches. While an all-loving God, who took days from the minutes, made us in his image, provided the tree of life that would save us from the sinning. He looked down and saw that our ways were conflicting, and brought the flood with the waves, and he slayed our existence. But God remembered Noah. He remembered him. Why? Because he mirrored him. Please, God, please remember us. He built the ark a little wide more in height. He said, I'ma bring a flood that's destroying life. They gon' tell you you crazy, ignore the hype. Make small rooms and a door for sight. Bring in all animals, even the forest type. Get the gopher wood for the board, make sure the floor is tight. You gon' hear cries in the waves. They trying to get saved, but be still while I make it rain 40 days, 40 nights. What about the dove and the raven? They represented more than flight. The dove came back, the raven didn't. That mean it died, which lets you know that darkness is still here. It's just now, all living has a chance to survive. Lucy, this your spiritual curfew. I'm a temp service closed down, something you'll never work through. If you shiver at the name Jesus, we gonna see what a verse do. Genesis chapter 3:14, that's where he cursed you. How could you bite the hand that birthed you? He tombstone earthed you, funeral home hearsed you, covered you in shame as he stripped you of your virtue. Satan, I heard you like to give death. When Jesus come back, he'll reimburse you. Hi, I'm chosen, I'm imperfect, but God gets my first fruit, and I'm allergic to the church suits. Ugh.